To be certified as an organic farmer, the use of synthetic herbicides or pesticides is strictly prohibited. So, what do the farmers do? Some use a giant flame-throwing tractor to blast the weeds away. The practice is apparently called flame weeding, and it makes agriculture look a lot more exciting. Of course, there is more to flame weeding than simply lighting a field on fire and hoping for the best. Using a giant propane tank and a special trailer modified to have 24 torches aimed toward the ground, the farmer burns away weeds before they can attack his organic crop. While flame weeding might seem like a 21st century solution, the first agricultural flame weeder, or flamer, was patented in 1852. However, it wasn't until the 1940s that flame weeding became recognized as an effective tool to control weeds in crops like cotton, sugar cane, and corn. By 1965, there were around 25,000 flame weeders in commercial use, but as herbicides became popular, flame weeding all but died out. However, the herbicides and pesticides used to kill weeds have long-term consequences. While spraying crops with herbicide can quickly eradicate weeds, concerns about their effect on the environment dominate. Humans, other plants, animals, water, and soil can all be exposed to and affected by these chemicals, even if they're not the target. With the recent interest in non-chemical weed control, gardeners and farmers are taking another look at flame weeding. Flame weeding is reportedly much more eco-friendly than chemical alternatives. A carefully directed flame fueled by natural gas or liquid propane raises the temperature within the weed, causing cells to break down and effectively kill weeds while causing little damage to the crop. Flames disrupt weed growth through heat, so it is important to burn when plants are dry and wind speed and direction are favorable. Both moisture and wind can reduce flame heat, reducing the effectiveness of flame application. Weeds are most susceptible to the heat of flames when they are 1 to 2 inches tall or at the 3 to 5 leaf stage. Exposing a weed seedling to flame for 1/10 of a second is usually sufficient to ensure control, although this may vary depending on the type and size of the weed. After the plant dies, it mixes with the soil and doesn't harm other plants. There's no toxic residue that travels into the water supply or which can be taken up by other creatures. The CO2 produced when flame weeding is offset by the lack of chemicals. Another advantage is that this process is that it is quite fast. Even the largest weeds can be eliminated within a few days. The biggest advantage of this type of pest prevention is that the weeds are destroyed from their roots, as the flames will prevent them from growing further. So it is a big asset if you want to have an organic farm that is chemical-free.